Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Media, here today with a video on the top 5 common causes of oil leaks. Oil leaks are really one of the most common issues on any car or vehicle with an internal combustion engine, and that's especially true with older vehicles. Chances are, if you have owned any cars or vehicles in your life that are older than 6 to 8 years old, there's a high likelihood that you have run into a couple oil leaks yourself. Fortunately, the good news is most oil leaks are relatively simple parts. It's usually easy to track down an oil leak, and usually the parts are inexpensive, so that can make repairs cheap. However, some common causes of oil leaks can be very labor-intensive jobs to actually replace the part that is causing the oil leak. So labor can be a big killer. However, the good news is oil leaks can be very cheap fixes, especially if you are hands-on and able to do a little bit of DIY work and knock out the oil leak repair and fixes on your own. That said, let's go ahead and jump right into the top 5 common causes of engine oil leaks. At number 1, we have a leaking oil filter or drain plug. This is really a simple issue and something that most commonly pops up right after changing the oil on your vehicle or getting an oil change somewhere. The oil filter should be replaced with every oil change, and then there's also the drain plug to actually drain out the old oil in the vehicle before changing it. So what happens occasionally is if you change the oil on your car or have it changed at a dealership, maybe something wasn't tightened down properly, like the drain plug was left a little bit loose or the oil filter housing wasn't properly installed. If you notice something like that right after changing the oil or having the oil changed in your vehicle, then go ahead and check those basic things. It could just be something as simple as that drain plug or the oil filter just not being properly installed or tightened down. At number 2, another very common cause of engine oil leaks is the valve cover gasket or valve cover gaskets. The valve cover gasket sits on the top of the engine and seals the valve cover to the cylinder head. So that gasket is just a part that becomes old, brittle, and begins cracking over time. Really, that's one of the common themes with a lot of causes of oil leaks and a lot of things that we'll be discussing in this video. A lot of these oil leaks really just boil down to seals, gaskets, O-rings, old parts that are made of rubber or rubber-like materials. With age and mileage, those parts just tend to wear down, become brittle, and begin cracking. So that is exactly the case with the valve cover gasket. Now, one thing is if you do have a minor leak from the valve cover gasket, you actually might not even notice any oil dripping onto the floor. Since again, the valve cover does sit at the top of the engine. Oftentimes, if there is an oil leak and just a couple small drips here and there, it will typically just leak onto the engine block or other hot components in the engine and be burned off. So usually with the valve cover gasket leak, you'll typically notice symptoms like a burning oil smell or see a little bit of light smoke coming from the engine bay, especially if it's coming from the top area. And again, it might not always actually make it onto the ground, so you might not even notice any drips or anything left behind from a valve cover gasket oil leak. So with the valve cover gasket, fortunately, it's just usually a simple rubber gasket or rubber-like gasket, and so the part itself generally costs about $10, $20, $30 on the high end. However, it tends to be about 1 to 3 hours of labor for most vehicles, so you'll be looking at about another $100 to $300 in labor if you end up at a repair shop, and some vehicles can certainly be more. For example, on some BMWs, I know from personal experience, replacing the valve cover gasket can be closer to a 5 to 8 hour job, and so in those cases, a lot of shops do charge pretty close to $1,000 for a lot of BMWs or similar cars where that labor is just a lot more extensive to actually fix the valve cover gasket. Moving on to the next common cause of oil leaks, we have the oil pan and oil pan gasket. So there are really two main things here. With the oil pan, it's possible that it was damaged and there's an issue with the actual oil pan and it's leaking. That's a lot less common than just the oil pan gasket simply leaking. The oil pan gasket just simply seals the oil pan to the bottom of the engine block where oil is then stored in the oil pan. Ultimately, very simple part with the oil pan gasket. It is going to be a little bit more expensive. These are typically thicker or higher quality gaskets than something like the valve cover, and it's generally best to replace all of the oil pan bolts as well when you do this job. So you'll be looking at probably about $50 to $150 in parts for an oil pan gasket. And labor on the oil pan can be very challenging. Some cars require the subframe being dropped, or there might even be more extensive things that need to be done. So it's not unusual for most cars for this to be about 2 to 4 hours of labor on the lower end. So probably about $200 to $400 in labor. However, quite a few vehicles, this will be a 6 to 8 hour job, if not even a little bit more time than that. So it's certainly very possible for the oil pan gasket to turn into a $1,000 job if you do have a car or an engine with a little bit more complex of a design and the oil pan isn't as easily accessible. Moving on to number four, we have oil leaks from the oil filter housing gasket. So we talked about the oil filter earlier. Of course, the oil filter needs somewhere to go, and that is inside of the oil filter housing, which that housing then contains a gasket, which is just another one of those parts that's a rubber or rubber like material, and they tend to wear down and degrade with age and mileage. Small gasket, super simple part, usually again about 10 or 20 bucks for the gasket itself. And labor, most cars will be about 1 to 3 hours of labor to actually replace the oil filter housing gasket. Some cars might be a little bit easier, some cars might be a little bit more complex, but ultimately it should be about $100 to $250 or $300 in labor for most vehicles. Throw in the parts, and so fortunately this is a pretty simple oil leak. And again, if you suspect you might have an oil filter housing oil leak, then just check that general area, see if you are seeing any noticeable oil leaks coming from the oil filter housing. Moving on to our fifth most common cause of oil leak, we have two things combined here, and that is the front and rear main seals, also known as the crankshaft seals. So there are two crankshaft seals, one at the front of the vehicle or one at the front of the engine and one at the rear of the engine. So these just seal the crankshaft, and these parts tend to just wear down and become brittle, start cracking with age and mileage, and begin developing oil leaks. These main seals are a little bit more expensive generally, maybe about $50 to $100 in parts. However, there can be a huge variance in the actual cost if you end up at a repair shop. It really just depends what year, model, and make of vehicle you have. Sometimes front and rear main seals may only be a few hours of labor. However, in a lot of cases, the front and rear main seals can be very challenging to replace and take quite a bit of time. So this is another one of those jobs that, while the parts are fairly inexpensive, if you end up at a repair shop, you could end up paying 6+ hours in labor and racking up $600+ in labor repair bills. Certainly something to consider if you do have a front or a rear main seal leak. If you are able to DIY, much like with all these issues we've discussed, you can save quite a bit by just DIYing these repairs and knocking them out on your own, even though they might just take a little bit of time to get the job done. Ultimately, that wraps up the top five causes of engine oil leaks. So as we discussed throughout the video, oil leaks usually boil down to some gasket, seal, or O-ring that has worn down and become brittle with age. It begins cracking and developing an oil leak. So it's not uncommon for a lot of these oil leaks to start off as a small drip here and there. And as those gaskets, seals, O-rings continue degrading and wearing down, they'll continue developing more cracks and bigger cracks, and the oil leaks will typically become worse. These oil leaks are all really most common on older vehicles, especially once you hit that roughly 6 to 8 year mark. Anything thereafter, that's really getting into the age and mileage for most vehicles, where a lot of these parts are just wearing down and becoming brittle and can start developing oil leaks. And that becomes more and more true as the car continues getting older. And that's why it's so common for a lot of 15+ year old vehicles to have oil leaks, especially if they haven't ever been addressed in the past. If you are able to DIY things and spend a weekend in the garage or spend a night in the garage, you can save a lot of money on these oil leaks, since ultimately it does boil down to these cheap, simple gaskets and other rubber-like parts that you can usually pick up for about $10 to $50. Labor is just really the biggest killer if you do end up at a repair shop. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and check out the description below for more awesome content. Thanks, guys.